Now I've been to New York, Texas, Midwest, and it all reminds me of California. Cause there's no place like California. California, A-A-T-L-M-I-A. DMV all reminds me of California. Cause there's no place like California. California, A.
New York, Texas, Midwest, and it all reminds me of California.
I got some out in Dallas, now I'm smelling like LA. Met a from Miami to the Machiavelli. Left the kids on the belly, left the vid on my celly. She ate like spaghetti, I'm hitting gas and dready. Met some killers in Memphis, like they from Oakland. Give me my flowers while I can smell them. Ain't talking about roses, literally.
Hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Today's matchup features one team who likes to get it done through the air. The Jaguars are top 10 in pass yards, and they're going up against the Titans, who will need to be ready to cover a lot of space. So, with the call of this Week 16 matchup, let's hand it over to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, the fans in teal and black are ready to lock down the bank as you get a look inside Everbank Field in Jacksonville, Florida. Today, it's a good matchup in the AFC South between the Tennessee Titans and the Jacksonville Jaguars. And on the ground they go with the running back. And this will go for five up to the 33.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
So the offense readies for a second and four. Now Bortles throwing on second down. He's got it, the tight end Jeff Heuerman. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And a long way to go for the offense here on second down. Bortles to throw on second down. And oh, right away, he lost the football. It's picked up by the Titans. And they're going to bring this one back. A fumble return touchdown for the Titans. So the defense forces the fumble. They get the score. And a guy on defense becoming offensive there, Charles.
And you know they love that. Any guy on defense loves to pick up the ball and have it in his hands and try and score himself. In this case, that's exactly what happened.
He'll be singing in the shower postgame. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return. This will be taken short. And some good coverage there by the kick team as they'll bring him down at the 16-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. On first and 10, here's Bortles. And some room to roam now. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. An excellent pickup of 34 yards. And the offense lining up first and 10. They'll come out in the pistol. And they'll run it here. And he'll be taken down right around the 41-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. And some options here for the offense on second and two. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They'll run it now out of the gun. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. Smart approach there, using the run to pick up the first. That was a defensive setup they prepared for this week, knowing that keeping it on the ground was the best way to attack it.
And that means also that they're able to read them pretty well. All the things they prepared for, when they get to the line of scrimmage, they see it in pre-snap recognition and know exactly how to attack based on their planning and preparation. And there's a completion to the tight end, and look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up, a lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
And an alley to run. And he cuts it right in into space. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. Corey Grant with another touchdown, number 24 on the year. And the Jaguars are within an extra point of tying this one up. And this one through the uprights and good. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback. Last year would have come out to the 20. This year they'll move it out to the 25-yard line. Forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. Offensive starters, here they are. And Delanie Walker, Charles, it's a guy that you and I said we wanted to discuss a bit.
Yeah, and we should, because remember, he came out of college as a wide receiver, so he's one of the early guys to move from a wide receiver position to tight end and still run routes as if he were a wide receiver. An excellent target.
On second down, here's Henry. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down. And time to take a look at the Jaguar defense.
Pitts Amukavara is a former first-round cornerback who's looking to become king.
And ready for third and 6. Third down, Mariota. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
A first down carry for Henry. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
They'll run it again with Henry. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about 4 for a first.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Mariota from the gun on third down. And he locates Walker, complete. And he's got the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 49.
I heard so much about the offense Marcus Mariota ran while he was at Oregon, about how people were just wide open, how he couldn't fail to hit them. But I always said the same thing. He sure as heck didn't miss them very often. Very accurate, even on short throws.
Yeah, he can go short. He can go deep, obviously. But he's really good with that short passing game.
Dart thrower, very accurate. Receivers love it.
Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return goes up to his own 17-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And now last drive so successful with the ground game, ending in a touchdown. Do you stick with that formula?
That would be the number one thing you would think of, but so many guys now would look at it and say, we've got them set up so well for play action, now's the time to take a shot.
Yeah.
But, you know, there was a
battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jason McCourty, and his guys will take over at the 30-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
All right, I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65. Mariota hands to Henry. And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
And that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense. Hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, but they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
Again, it's Henry. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. With the former Volunteer Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Titans with a football here to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. Throwing is Mariota, trying for White, and it's intercepted. And now off to the races, down the right side. The 40, the 20, 10, and he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Short throw, pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And the Titans getting set to go. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
To Henry. Now Mariota. And that one got tipped. Kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I got to get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
Offense in a little bit of a bind here. 9 yards to go on third down. Working out of the gun, Mariota. And that is incomplete. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and that just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
And now a high kick trying to pin him back. taken from just outside the 30. 44-yard punt, return of 9. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackler was there right away for a loss of yardage.
They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. On second down, here's Bortles. And the catch made here by Marquise Lee. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
Bortles looking for Cooks, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Avery Williamson. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. Tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Following the interception here, Mariota. Walker with a grab, left side. And he'll be down deep into Jacksonville territory. It's a big play on third down for the Titans. 48 yards. They come up in an offset eye. They'll try to run for it with Henry. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Second down, goal to go from the 6. They'll give Henry another shot. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the 1. A nice run there as he picks up 6. It's going to be 3rd and goal now. 2 straight shots on the ground. Now on 3rd, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that 2nd down is the time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4 down territory.
Trying to punch it in with Henry. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1.
Partners, decision time now. I know it's still just the second quarter, but you have an opportunity to either kick the field goal or go for it and try and score a big-time touchdown. This is why the head coaches get paid the big bucks.
The offense is staying out there. Here we go on 4th and goal from the 1. They come out here in the eye. They'll run for it with Henry. And he is going to lose yardage here. The big back Derrick Henry held out of the end zone. And the Jaguars are able to come up with a goal line stand. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And tough starting field position here. And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. It's caught right side. It turns. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back with more from Jacksonville. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back after this. Defense in a good spot. Let's see how the offense responds with a second and 13 now. From deep in their own territory, they look to throw. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he is out of bounds, able to get it across the 20-yard line. And they talked about how important the passing game was going to be against that defensive look. Good job there going to the air for the first down.
It's all about preparation. It's all about planning. And then it's about execution. So they put it all together in practice. Okay, this is what we think we're going to see. This is how they get to it. And then when the game comes, read it and attack it.
And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play. But if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. I don't know who all is to blame there, but I love seeing pick sixes.
Nothing like seeing someone pluck it out of the air and go the other way and see people try to change directions. Hard to do.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Out comes the Jacksonville offense as they get set to take over here. Give him eight on the play, and that'll make it a second down. And some extras coming up on the line here, ready for the blitz. Now Allen, out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he's going to be out of bounds, but able to take it inside the 40-yard line. He got 29 yards that time.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
And give him a gain of 37.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
And now the offense operates in the red zone. Shift together here from the D-line. And here we go on first and goal. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Corey Grant, his 25th touchdown. Tying Emmitt Smith for the fifth most in one season. And the Jaguars add on to their lead. After the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. This fielded at the two. Oh, what a move. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And last time, they had it fourth and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
A simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow them to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it into the end zone. We'll see what they do. Kendall Wright, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Throwing again, Mariota on second and 10. And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one. Down down here for the offense after the incomplete pass. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? So third and five, third and medium here. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Mariota from the gun on third down. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. We heard them talk before the game about utilizing the intermediate passing game this week. It works for them there. They move the chains.
And we saw them work on it in practice as well. And most teams take a period at a time to work on different things. They put a couple of periods of work into the intermediate passing game, and now we know exactly why. They got the look that they were seeking, and they were able to take advantage of it.
And Matthews has it right side. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Trying to lay one up deep. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
I like the boldness and I like that they took a shot downfield, but it was well covered. He's able to get a hand in and knock it away.
So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. On third down, Mariota. And he locates Walker, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And now a first down following that long gain. Mariota now to throw on first down. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. That throw good for four. It's second down.
All right, say it with me now. There's a lot of different words we come up with. Maybe we go back and forth after that play, getting his toes tapped down to make that catch. Crafty.
Yep.
Wiley. Oh, definitely.
All the veteran names.
You name it, has every move in the book and continued to get better throughout his career so he can make that type of a catch.
That is caught right at the 10-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. Fresh set of downs here. First and 10. Here's Mariota. And incomplete. He dropped it in the end zone. Rishard Matthews, the intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to.
And now the Jags defense deciding to call a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And Succuff will put this one right through, and the drive will wind up yielding three. So they're still down, but they are able to salvage three here heading into the lockers.
This is what you work on from the beginning of training camp. Heading into the half, put some points on the board. No matter what the score says at that point, you've accomplished what you set out to do.
Short kick. One of the up middle take it down. And they'll be set up with good field position here as he gets this up over the 40-yard line. All right, Larry, thank you. A fairly tight game here as we get set to resume play in this second half. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This one taken from the 7. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. Henry, the lone man in the the backfield. He'll get the football here. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Another carry for the rookie. It's Henry. And he is going to lose yardage here. That'll go as a loss of 5. And that'll make it 3rd and 13.
Partner, I think the easy thing now would be to just abandon the run and start throwing the football at all costs. But I've been in so many games where it doesn't work running the ball, doesn't work running the ball, and then something pops, and now you get something going. I'm not so sure to just abandon your game plan this early in the second half.
3rd and 1 here for Mariota. The catch is made by Kendall Wright. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. One up to about the 38. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's 2nd and 4.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved him and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
This carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a 3rd and 4. The shotgun. It's Mariota. And this is going to be incomplete. Rishard Matthews, the intended target. And it's 4th and 4. Here's Brett Kern now as he'll punt it away for the second time. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. This is taken around the 12. A good return there. Call it 13 yards. And the offense will come back onto the field with a 1st and 10. Here comes the Jags offense now. Time for their first possession of half number 2. They were able to get the ball back here. Didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Yeah, how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. Offense needs something here on 2nd down. It is 2nd and long. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Allen. Now they go screen. It's complete. Evades the tackler and now some space. A big play there on the catch and run. 41 yards.
As we continue to advance in the NFL, as people continue to scout players, they really don't care as much about body types as they care about those guys who can make people miss, run through tackles, and gain all that additional run after catch. Anybody who has that ability, they want them on their team.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Ten yards still left on 2nd down. Now Allen. It's caught right side. It turns. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. Now a play fake here on first down. Out to his left. Trying to get it to Thomas, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off.
I tell you, you know how press conference is when you sign guys like this. He's been a real difference maker so far. That's now two interceptions for him in the game. And when you're getting contributions up and down your 53-man roster, you're going to be all right.
And not great starting field position here for the offense. Following the interception here, Mariota. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Prince Amukamara. And they'll have the ball set up in the red zone at the 16-yard line. And now out come the Jags. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told them, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football, and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. It'll be a gain of four, and that'll bring up a third down.
Well, there really wasn't much there, but a completion is a completion. A tough third down awaits them.
In danger of squandering their great field position as they come up on a third and seven. They'll drop the throw. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by the linebacker, Avery Williamson. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Titan offense now working their way back onto the field. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Credit the tackle to the second rounder, Miles Jack.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
Now a second down throw for Mariota. And complete to the tight end Walker, right side. Call it a gain of seven, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Hey, when Marcus Mariota was at Oregon, throwing to the tight end wasn't much of an option, was it? That spread offense, you didn't have him on the field too much. Now he's got one of the best in the game in Delanie Walker.
Now last year, Walker led all the tight ends with 94 catches. They go play action here on first down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let him know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. When they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play.
And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Henry will get it. He's been busy today. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. And yet again, this run game just continues to be completely shut off.
Completely stymied. I mean, they're trying to get some consistency, trying to find places to roam. They just haven't been there throughout this game.
And the D looking like they may blitz. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. They'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
D two plays in a row, the defense won, stacking up the running game. They've got to feel good about themselves, but something has to be in the back of their minds. Are we being set up for something big? They've got to be careful.
Third and long here for Mariota. Finding time. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. A great read, and it's picked off. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. Second down following the run. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. Brandon Cooks, the receiver he was going after, and it's fourth and three.
When teams take shots at the end zone, you've got to defend it the same way you would defend the first down sticks. You defend the goal line exactly the same way. They can't cross that. You play through the receivers. And on that play, that's exactly what they did and batted it away.
So an empty possession there. What do you think went wrong, Charles?
Well, it looked like maybe the plant leg might have given way just a little. And when that happens, guys have a tendency to pull through the ball to compensate. And in doing so, sent this one off target.
They come out here in the eye. And he'll be hit from behind and taken down. A man who missed his entire rookie season, Dante Fowler, in there to get him. And that is sack number 15 for him on the year. They'll run it now out of the gun. To use his blockers to get this up over the 40. 8 yards here, so that gets him back within striking distance. And now it's third down.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
On third down, Mariota. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. Well contained there defensively. The screen gets only a yard, and it's fourth.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Desperation time. Mariota on fourth down. He's got time. It comes, and he lost the football. Mariota had it jarred loose. The Titans try it, but ultimately they fail on fourth down. And the Jags take over in terrific field position. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah,
get a little closer. Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
And the offense here just looking to stay in bounds, complete the short passes, and put this game on ice. They'll run it now out of the gun. And only able to muster a couple, down to about the 27. Daquan Jones in on the tackle there. And the Titans going to signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter.
Nowhere, baby, nowhere. Let's go. Way to go, deep. Way to go, deep.
They got to get to the 20 to keep the drive alive on third down. Now the defense definitely showing blitz here. Allen. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the right hash, this from 44 yards out. And Myers able to knock it through, and that'll make this a seven-point game. So, Charles, I think from a defensive perspective, you have to look at that field goal there and consider it a win.
You were able to keep them within a touchdown, so no question about it. That was the kind of stand that keeps you in ball games.
And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Titans offense now, they get set to head back out here. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. Good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
Second down and four. It's a five-receiver set. Three to the left, two to the right. Mariota. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
They come out here in the eye. Gonna give this time to the tailback. Shedding the tackler, and it gives him some room. Oh, he's got a little daylight. Touchdown, Jaguars. Corey Graham, his 26th touchdown, drawing even with Marshall Faulk for the fourth most in a single season. And the lead is up to 14. And the forced turnover on defense leads to 6 points. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And it's a short kick, taken right around the 19. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Out come the Titans now. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets them to second and four.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
They'll come up now in the Wildcat package. Correct snap. This is Henry. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Henry takes a direct snap. They run it for the first time to the backup, Murray. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
We just saw another example of how the defense is winning this game. Really at the point of attack, the offensive line is just getting pushed around. I think now as a play caller, you've got to give them a little bit of help. Maybe you keep your tight ends a little bit more. Maybe the running backs help you a little bit with the pass blocking. But you've got to help them get some confidence because you can't abandon the play calling right now.
2 yards gets them back to where they started, but now third and 10.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
And Charles, you know what coaches always tell us. We want to win our home games. That much we know. We want to protect our home turf. They got that done in this one.
Exactly right. When you start a season, everyone's goal, win all of your home games, split your road games, and you're likely going to be in the playoffs. But when you win at home, boy, what a great feeling that is. You don't even mind if people are at your house when you get home after a win like that.
So for the Jags, it's a critical win for them as it gets them to 9-6 on the year. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Indianapolis Colts. Meanwhile, for Tennessee, the slide continues as they drop now to 3-12. And they'll be at home next week for a date with the Houston Texans. So that's a wrap. For Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The Jaguars are winners here as we say so long from Jacksonville.
away your inhibitions. Let the beast in you just get loose. We all young, wild, and different. We can all get from a little. I know you're terrified by what the future lies, but there's no compromising. It's my way or the highway. We all just slave the lust, heart building, breaking trust. Don't get wild when we come out. Like, don't get loud when the come out. That's instant. Give up what your friends think. Tell they bougie. Go wait in line with them lame. Talking real rap. Tell them break your neck. Gonna bust the rhyme. Throw on down. Pass it around. Everybody got guilty pleasures. Mine just tend to catch me cases. Handcuffs, police inspections, lawyers, judges, allegations. Turn on your favorite station. You hear the same old song. I feel like, dog, I'm about to drop the bomb. Blow on down, pass it around.
Troubles in the air.
Bring a friend along.